WWE's gigantic showcase event, WrestleMania 35, taking place this coming weekend, I decided to take this advantage as both a wrestling fan and a gamer to take a look back at all the great pro wrestling games that have been released over the years and rank them in what is my top 10 wrestling video games of all time. So let's not waste any more time and get straight into it. Number 10, WWE 2K14. Squeezing into the 10th spot on this list comes WWE 2K14, the first game in the current 2K series and the last WWE game released on PS3 and Xbox 360. Knowing how well 2K Sports had done with the NBA games, I was thrilled when I heard they'd be taking over the WWE titles following the closure of THQ. With that being said, I was cautious with this being their first attempt at a wrestling game, and to a point, I was right to be, as this wasn't perfect with a few gameplay issues. Though, what it did do was bring us 30 years of WrestleMania, which to this day is still one of my favourite game modes of all time. It gives the player a chance to play through some of the biggest moments in WrestleMania history, which included 45 matches and let you play through the early years of WrestleMania as the immortal, and somewhat racist, Hulk Hogan, through to the rise of Shawn Michaels and Bret Hart. By the time the game mode has gotten to the Attitude Era, with the likes of Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock, and the Ruthless Aggression Era that introduces John Cena and Batista, you realise just how giant the roster is here and how much WWE 2K14 was made for true wrestling fans that love their wrestling history. Cracking start, 2K. Number 9, WWE All-Stars. Larger than life, over the top, flamboyant and full of energy are all phrases that perfectly describe professional wrestling, and also perfectly describes WWE All-Stars. Released in 2011 by THQ on PS3, PS2, Xbox 360, Nintendo 3DS, and the PSP, All-Stars went out of its way to be completely different to other wrestling games on the market. Whereas for years, most wrestling games were designed with realism in mind, this went in the complete opposite direction, making it stand out as an all-time favourite. It's a goofy and wacky arcade game that I found myself enjoying with friends way more than I expected to, and was a nice break from the super realistic titles that were released around it. The only problem holding this game back from being higher in this list for me is the lack of game modes outside of just messing about with friends, with only the Fantasy Warfare mode available here, which just had the player play through fantasy matches that they could just select to do an expedition mode anyway. Number 8, WWF Attitude. Okay, admittedly, this one gets its spot mostly through outright nostalgia. Released in 1999 by Acclaim on N64 and PS1, WWF Attitude was released at the height of wrestling's popularity and had a roster that would impress any fan even to this day. Unlike a lot of games on this list, if you were to pick up and play Attitude now, you would likely throw your controller across the room in frustration as you struggled to get to grips with the overly complicated controls and general slow nature of this game. Though, as a 12-year-old kid with nothing else to do with my time but to learn every combination of buttons for every move to beat my friends, I loved it. Add to that the fond memories of wrestlers having full entrances and cool little catchphrases before they started their match, and it's easy to see why I remember the good over the bad when thinking of this classic. Unfortunately, it would be somewhat overshadowed by a certain game released a year later. More on that later. Number 7. Fire Pro Wrestling World. The latest addition in the Fire Pro Wrestling series, this game could easily be considered as a cult favourite, with previous iterations mostly played on PC by gamers who were just as interested in modding the game as they were in playing it. But last year, this version was released not just to PC, but also on the PS4 by developer Spike Chunsoft, with the aim of getting more casual players interested, and I would say that has been a successful mission. Teaming up with Japanese juggernauts New Japan Pro Wrestling, Fire Pro was always guaranteed success in the East, but over the past year, it seems more and more Westerners are discovering this hidden gem. With its trademark look of yesteryear, it has appealed to old-school wrestling fans that don't necessarily want the most modern wrestling simulator provided by 2K Sports, and would prefer something that resembles the games they grew up playing. More specifically, games that use the famous AKI engine. Fire Pro does an incredible job achieving this, and gives players the most freedom when it comes to custom content, meaning somebody like me can lose hours upon hours just creating and downloading different wrestlers, arenas, and more to create their perfect fantasy wrestling world. Number 6, WWE 2K19. 2K19 is obviously the latest addition in the long-running WWE 2K series, and although it may not be the most revolutionary of games, I find myself having to include it just as an example of how a game developer can build upon what is essentially the same game year on year and end up with something that to a newcomer will be mightily impressive. Sure, 2K19 could be criticised for not taking a big enough leap from 2K18, but I don't think many people can argue that out of all the games in this current series, the latest is the best. It's just about the best looking wrestling game on the market by default of being the latest, and the developers have also fine-tuned all its game modes by this point to almost perfection. Universe mode, although still flawed, is probably the biggest it has ever been, and for someone like me, is a hell of a lot of fun when you begin to include all the non-WWE wrestlers that are available to download from the creation suite and to be thrown into the universe mode. Say what you will, but I personally still lose hours upon hours to the latest edition of these titles due to the deep creation suite and realistic graphics that other wrestling games cannot provide. Number 5. Def Jam Vendetta. Safe to say that this is the only game on this list that does not include any wrestlers. Released in 2003 on PS2 and GameCube by EA Sports Big, this seemed to come out of nowhere like a quickfire RKO. With EA rightly getting critically destroyed for their last attempt at a wrestling game, WCW Backstage Assault, they went for something out of left field, with a wrestling game that pitted famous rappers against one another. The game featured some massive names such as Ludacris, DMX, Method Man, Redman, and way more. Okay, so the good idea is in place, but how well did it play? Absolutely incredible as it happens. EA was smart here and looked at what had worked before. With AKI having the best reputation for making wrestling games, they just used a more simplified version of that famous engine, and it was enough to satisfy most fans. With fresh yet famous characters, a tried and trusted gameplay engine, a decent story mode, as well as a killer soundtrack, Def Jam proved to be a major player in the wrestling video game market, and its sequel, Def Jam Fight for New York, was arguably even better, but I'm going to give this spot to Vendetta for daring to be different and succeeding massively. Number 4. SmackDown vs. Raw 2006. THQ's SmackDown vs. Raw series was a bit hit and miss throughout the years, but it was the 2006 release on PS2 that has always stuck with me as being my favourite for one massive reason. The introduction of GM mode. As a fan of wrestling and video games, I can't explain how excited I was for this new mode. Me and my friends would spend hours and hours fantasy booking wrestling shows and even going as far as to do so by using older games and nothing more than a piece of paper and our imaginations. But here comes SmackDown vs. Raw 2006, the first game that actually let the player take control of a brand, either SmackDown or Raw funnily enough, and compete against an opposition general manager, either player or CPU, to see who would have the most fan support come the end of the wrestling year. It included the ability to do a draft, set up feuds, manage wrestlers' contracts, and even steal wrestlers from your rival promotion. It's a mode that ticked all the boxes for me, and a mode that is still frequently requested to this day. Doubt the popularity of GM mode? Just take a look on YouTube at current WWE wrestler Xavier Woods' gaming channel, where he and fellow wrestler Tyler Breeze still play 2006's GM mode to this very day. Number 3. WCW NWO Revenge. It will be no surprise to many wrestling fans to see the first AKI developed game debut so high on this list. AKI are famed for having the best game engine when it comes to pro wrestling video games, even to this day. Many have tried to replicate it, see earlier entries such as Def Jam and Fire Pro, but none have quite captured the magic of the earlier games, such as WCW NWO Revenge. This was actually the second WCW game released by the developer, as it was a sequel to 1997's WCW vs. NWO World Tour. But it was WCW NWO Revenge a year later that took the headlines, as it managed to build upon its predecessor to make what was heralded as a near-perfect game. The weight behind every grapple, the realistic feel to every move, as well as easy-to-pick-up-and-play controls, made this a truly spectacular game for wrestling fans of all ages. This was backed up by the sales of the game, as this was reportedly the best-selling third-party game on the N64 console up until that point. This was probably helped by the massive popularity of WCW at the time, thanks to its NWO storyline throughout the late 90s. Meaning, putting NWO in the title was probably an incredibly smart move by all involved. Number 2. WWE SmackDown, Here Comes the Pain. You'll often find that the debate over which wrestling game is the best ever made often comes down to arcade versus realism. those who want a beat-em-up style game, more in line with something like Fire Pro, versus those who want a game that more reflects the wrestling they see on their TV, which is more what 2K aimed to do. I believe that 2003's SmackDown Here Comes the Pain, released exclusively to the PlayStation 2 by Yuke's and THQ, was the first and only wrestling game to achieve both. The visuals, for its time, were fantastic, making the whole presentation the closest thing to real-life WWE we had seen up until that point. The gameplay had also been completely revamped from its prequel, meaning that when Goldberg would lift his opponent up for his jackhammer finisher, or The Rock would raise his rival high for the rock bottom, it would feel more realistic than ever. That was until you decided to take the fight backstage. This is where the chaos would ensue, as all of a sudden, it felt like realism was out the door and left in the ring. Once backstage, you could throw your opponent off lorries, buildings, and anything else ridiculously high. You could tombstone pile drive your enemy off a ledge and through a table. Hell, you could even go outside, jump onto a helicopter, and dive off it. That was the beauty of Here Comes the Pain. The game had you covered no matter what you wanted from a wrestling game. Sure, put it on today, and those impressive visuals may no longer be all that great, but for its time, it was untouchable. Number 1. WWF No Mercy. Was this number 1 spot ever in doubt? Yes, it's the most obvious pick for a list like this, but there's a reason for that. Much like the above mentioned WCW NWO Revenge, WWF No Mercy was developed by AKI and published by THQ, and was the last wrestling game they would develop for the N64, and what a way to go out this was. To put it into perspective, just how well loved these AKI games are, the top 4 of this list could have easily been the 4 games they made for N64, and not many wrestling fans would argue with that. Released in 2000, a year after its predecessor, WrestleMania 2000, in 1999, No Mercy was the crowning achievement of wrestling games. The gameplay and controls were flawless, and once you and your friends had mastered it, there wasn't any multiplayer games in any genre that could match it for pure entertainment. It wasn't just the gameplay and mechanics that it nailed, it also set the standard for customization in wrestling games for years to come, allowing an, at the time, unheard of amount of options for creating your own wrestler. Me and my friends would lose the majority of our summer holidays just creating our own custom characters with their own custom movesets to fight each other over and over again without it ever getting boring. No Mercy is so good that it's even managed to stand the test of time. It managed to keep me busy for a good few years. Even after other wrestling games came out, it would usually be a case of playing them for a little while before going back to No Mercy for the rest of the year. A trend that would pretty much continue until the release of the runner-up in this list, SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. It's also worth pointing out that using the creation tools provided with the game, players have managed to create the more modern-day wrestlers, which means that WWF No Mercy is even played by fans to this very day. And that isn't surprising, given that many still see it as a superior wrestling game to any game that has followed it since. And to be honest, I think I might agree with them. So there you have it, my top 10 wrestling video games of all time. Do you agree? Or am I completely wrong? Have I missed out your favourite, maybe? Let me know in the comments below. And until next time, I've been Mikey from respawning.co.uk, and I'll catch you next time.